So hello everyone, welcome back to the mathematics class. So today in this video we are going to differentiate between like and unlike decimals, and of course we are going to learn how to compare the like decimals and find out the greatest and smallest decimal from the given decimal numbers. So let us begin. So first of all, we must know what are like and unlike decimals. So as you can see children, 0.37, 4.39, 5.04, 264.93, 46.47. All these numbers have two places or two decimal numbers. Decimal numbers are those numbers which are just after the decimals. So there are two numbers or two digits, we can say that there are two digits after the decimal in each of the number. So these are known as like decimals. So let us talk about the definition. That is, two or more decimals are said to be like decimals if the number of digits in their decimal part is same, because here we have, see, two digits in all the numbers. Now let us see to the next one. Here are some examples like 0.7, 4.39, 54.014, 2.2113. So as you can see, here we have only one digit in the decimal part. Here we have two digits, here we have three digits, and here we have four digits. That means no number have the same number of digits in the decimal part. So these are known as the unlike decimals. So let us talk about the decimals. The definition, that is, two or more decimals are said to be unlike decimals if the number of digits in their decimal part is different, because here we have different number of digits in each number. So that's why these are said to be unlike decimals. Okay children, so here you can see how to convert it. As you can see, a number 3.429, so number of digits in the decimal part is here is 3, yes, because there are three numbers in the decimal part, and here it is 65.3, so number of digits in the decimal part is 1 here. So the two decimals above are unlike decimals. Now how to convert them? So as you can see, to make them like decimals, we write zeros behind the decimal part of the decimal number which has less number of digits. So as we can see, here are three digits and here only one digit. So what we will do, we will see how many digits are there. 1, 2, 3 digits. That means if we convert this number and if we add two more zeros in this, so it will also have three digits in the decimal part. So what we did, we have just inserted two zeros here. So now here number of digits are 1, 2, 3 after decimal. Here also 1, 2, 3 after the decimal. So now they are like decimals. Children, we can't put or we can't write any other digit except 0 over here, because if we write down, suppose if we write down 1 over here, so it will change the value. So 0, 0 will not affect anything, will not affect in the value. That's why we are always inserting number of zeros, whatever is required. So now I hope children you have understood that how to convert the like decimal, unlike decimals into the like decimals. Let us see some questions related to converting unlike to like decimals. So these are, change the following decimals into the like decimals. So here we have two numbers, 0.5 and 0.42. So as we can see here, 0.5 has only one digit in the decimal part, and here we have two digits in the decimal part. So maximum number is 2. So that means if we insert here 10, so we will get two decimal parts, two digits in the decimal part. So it will be 0.50 and 0.42. This is the answer. Like this, we can convert the unlike decimals into the like decimals. Now they have equal number of digits in the decimal part. Let us see one more example. So here we have 9.215 and 9.3. So if I have written like this, so easily it is visible that it has three digits in the decimal part and it has only one digit in the decimal part. So if I insert two zeros over here, it will become same. So I have done here, I have inserted two zeros, so now we have three digits in the decimal part, and here also we have three digits in the decimal part. So like this, we have to convert the unlike decimals into the like decimals. Now we have comparing. Comparing means now how to compare or how to arrange in ascending or descending order. So I am going to tell you only the descending order part. Ascending order is also just like same, but just you need to reverse it. So we can see here, arrange the following in descending order. So here we have been given three decimal numbers and we have to arrange them into descending order. So it is, we have 2.04, 24.6 and 23.5. So first step is to convert into the like decimals. Yes, very good. So it was 2.04 and it has maximum number of digits. It has two digits, it has one digit and it has only one digit. So what I did, I just inserted 1 1 0s over here in these two numbers. So it has become, see, you can see. So the 24.6 has become 24.60 and 23.5 have become 23.50. So now all have two decimal places, 1 2 1 2 and 1 2, all have two digits in the decimal numbers. So now they are like decimals. But while converting into ascending or descending order or while comparing, the first step is to just convert into like decimals. Now second step is to check the whole number part. So here we have the whole number part is 2. Here the whole number part is 24 and here the whole number part is 23. So I guess there is no need to change into the like decimals also, because by observing the whole number part, we can easily know that 24 is the greatest number. So 24 will come at the first part, 24.60. Then 23 is a smaller number than 24, so it will be 23.50. And then we have 2.04 because it is the smallest number over here. So it is 2.04. So like this, we can convert the, we can arrange the numbers, the decimal numbers into the descending order. But keep in mind the symbol also, this is the descending order symbol. And if you are doing ascending, so this will be the ascending order symbol. So let us move now. Next part is three digits have been given, three numbers have been given. It is 0.1, 1 and 3. So I have converted 1 and 3 into the like decimals to 0.1. As we know that we have one digit in this number, after the decimal we have no digit, we have no digit. So what I did, I just inserted 0 after the decimal. So 1 has become 1.0, 3 have become 3.0. So now we have numbers 3.0, 1.0 and 0.1. So again we will check the whole number part. It is 3, it is 1 and it is 0. So of course 3 will come at the first because we are arranging in descending order. So it will be 3.0, then it will be 1.0 and then it will be 0.1. This is the answer. Now children, there is another question which says that which of the following is the greatest and smallest decimal number? So here we have been given some numbers, some decimal numbers. So what we can do, we can convert them into the like decimals first of all. So let us see the maximum number of digits. It has 2, it has 2, it has 3. It has 3 and it has 2. That means 3 is the maximum number of digits in the decimal part. So we will make all the numbers with the 3 decimal, with the digits in the decimal part. So it has 3 now, it has 3, it has already 3, 3. And one more. So it is like that. So now they all are like decimals. Now we can observe without converting them into like decimals also how, first of all, we can see the decimal, the whole number part. It is 1, it is 8, it is 7, it is 5 and it is 5. So which is the greatest number? Yes, of course, you are right. 8.290 is the greatest number. Here we have 8.290. Now 1, 7, 5 and 5. So which is the smallest number? Yes, absolutely right. 1.740 is the smallest number that I have written over here. It is 1.740. So this is the answer how we are going to do this one question. Now let us see the next question. This is a word problem kind of question, just a simple one. Mickey has rupees 100.08 while Suraj has rupees 100.80. So who has got more money? Of course, so first of all you will write down the statement. Mickey has rupees this much and Suraj has rupees this much. Now easily you can observe it is 100 and 100, both are same common, the whole number part is same in both 100 and 100. So we can't compare by just seeing the whole number part. So what we will do, we will see the decimal part. It is 0.8 and it is 80. 0.80. That means it is 8 and it is 80. So which is bigger? Yes, this one. So Suraj has more money. So I hope, children, you have understood the concept of like and unlike decimals now, and you are able to do the given assignment. Thank you, children. Bye-bye. Stay safe. Stay at home. See you soon.